Yeah, so I arrived 40 years ago, exactly 40 years ago. No, that was September 13, 1975. I arrived at the airport, and I came to McGill, to this department. It was mining and metallurgical engineer. We're housed in another building where mining is right now. There were a couple of friends that were together in Greece that were waiting for me. We shared the same apartment. It was a very modest scholarship, something like a couple of $1,000 to live for the whole year.
Okay.
But enough, you know, to start my studies, to support my studies and start my career here. And, you know, I registered. I had a supervisor, Professor Distin. He was a hydrometallurgist. And so Professor Williams, who was the chairman of the department, he said, you go to work with this professor, you get the scholarship to work with that professor. So I started for a couple of months. I said, hydrometallurgy, I don't know, I want to work with steel making, you know. Like I said before, steel was much more magical as a material, as an alloy, etc. And I go to see Professor Williams, said, can I change supervisor, change project, please? He said, yes, you can change project, but the scholarship does not follow you.
Okay.
You are on your own if you change project. So I said, no, it's fine. No, and I have all my respect, and I'm thankful to Professor Distin as supervisor, how patient was with me, you know, coming from another country and so on, supported me. So I did my master's, and hydrometallurgy became mon métier, the expertise. I became an expert in hydrometallurgy, and really I loved the whole thing, to the extent that, you know, still I'm teaching hydrometallurgy 40 years after. Although at the beginning, you know, I had my doubts, and I'm very thankful to Professor Williams, who insisted, no, George, you do this project or no project for you.